Before the module is created, we can use a config method to configure how it gets set up. The config method takes a function. UIRouter includes a lot of functionality. Two components we'll be using are state provider and URL provider. We'll inject both of these into the config function. Providers are like services, but only providers can be used for a module configuration. We can now use state provider to set up the different states of our app. Let's start out with the default state and call it home. To add a state to our app, we call .state, give the state a name, again we're going to use home, and give it a configuration object with the URL for this state, the template to use. Our app is already using the default template, so we'll link to that, and the controller to load for that template. We've used state provider to set up a state for the app. We need to use URL router provider to load the home state by default. So the app state management is all set up, but there's one last thing. We need to tell UIRouter where to insert this template. We can do that with the directive UIView. We have access to this directive because we've included the UIRouter module into our project. UIRouter is now handling our app's state. Let's add a new state for an individual menu item. Let's create an item state. We also need to create the template and controller for this item. Pay attention to this right here, the colon ID. We can use dynamic content in our routing. Let's quickly generate a template and a controller for an item. I've also created a few JSON files with more details about the menu items. When the URL is item/someMenuID, the ID will be accessible in the item controller by using the stateParams service. We'll also add in the FoodFinder service so that we can retrieve the item. We'll use the getItem function and look up the item by its ID. Then when it's returned the JSON file, we'll set it to the item's data property. The getItems function is very similar to getMenu, except that it gets a single item specified by the ID. Let's make the name a link to that item's detail page. UIRouter gives us the UISref directive to switch between states. We want to switch to the item state and pass along a value. The state expects an ID, which we'll set to the item's ID. Now it's just filling out the template for the item. Let's have it show the item's name, the image of the menu item, and its rating and description. And now our app can be in the default state with the menu showing, or it can be in an item state. How awesome is that?